I didn't realize this until I read your article, and everybody should read this article. It's over at theamericanprogress.org. I realized after reading your article that Rex Tillerson being named to be Secretary of State was a red herring, a distraction, so people wouldn't notice the other Exxon Mobil puppets who are being installed within the cabinet. So Rex Tillerson, if he becomes Secretary of State, how does that benefit Exxon Mobil?
So I think, yeah, in the obvious way that he has been a lifelong Exxon employee, most recently their CEO, it's tough to believe that maybe he would be looking out for the best interests of everyday Americans rather than still holding on to some of his corporate interests. And so as Secretary of State, his relationships with other countries is primarily how he could benefit ExxonMobil while he's not there. Exxon produces oil and gas in 22 countries, and I think most recently have had plans to expand that. We also know that Rex Tillerson has close ties to Russia. That's what, during his confirmation hearing, that he got questioned on that a lot. And there is a lot of oil and gas in Russia and a lot of oil and gas that ExxonMobil would like to be further producing but haven't been able to right now because of U.S. sanctions against Russia.
We put in sanctions against Russia after they seized Crimea, which maybe they're entitled to. Some say they had every right to take Crimea. And we ended up blocking a pipeline that Putin wanted and Exxon wanted. If he becomes Secretary of State, pipelines fall under the purview of state, like the big pipeline from the Canadian tar sands that we're still waiting to hear about, right?
Exactly. So international pipelines are also under the purview of the Secretary of State. And the most famous one is, I think, that you referenced is the Keystone XL pipeline that President-elect Trump has talked a lot about. As Secretary of State, Tillerson could, you know, speed up the approval of international pipelines. And that would help Exxon because they have a lot of stock in the Canadian tar sands. I think about 35% of their holdings most recently were in tar sands. So getting those to market could really be a windfall for them.
So aggravating. It really is.
It is. And I think you're right that in some ways, you know, a little bit of a red herring, it seems so obvious that Rex Tillerson might help benefit ExxonMobil. But really, Trump has seemed to try and stock his cabinet with as many people funded by the oil and gas industry, and even ExxonMobil in particular, that they could really have some impactful decisions for the future of the company.
Yeah. How do you keep from being overwhelmed by all this information? How do you keep your head on straight? Because it's definitely a concerted effort by Trump and Bannon and Kushner. They're really manipulating the public, just throwing so much stuff at us. It's like a document dump. There's just so much corruption. You can't, your head is spinning. How do you stay focused and not just, how do you get out of bed?
I don't know that I have, I do, but I don't know that I have a great answer for that, except for that you're completely right. I mean, this Wednesday they had Trump's first press hearing in so long, and they had Tillerson going and Sessions going and Congress doing a Votorama trying to repeal Obamacare. We're seeing almost every single one of these cabinet nominees that I mentioned are having hearings one day after the next. I think it's Zinke on Tuesday, Pruitt on Wednesday, and Rick Perry on Thursday. And so it really is just a, you know, a document dump that try and get a handle on and try and pick out what's really most important.
You're listening to Highlights from The David Feldman Show, heard nationwide on Pacifica Radio, or as a podcast on iTunes, Stitcher, and now YouTube. Please subscribe to this channel. For more information, go to davidfeldmanshow.com. Thank you for listening.
The David Feldman Radio program is made possible by listeners like you. You sad, pathetic humps.